Following the issuance of a terror alert by the UK government to Uganda early this month, security agencies in the country have been on high alert. From increased security foot and motorized patrols in and around the city, the security agencies have gone ahead to conduct numerous security operations in the border districts, especially those bordering DR Congo, which are more prone to ADF infiltration. According to police, an operation held in Ntoroko district over the weekend saw 34 suspected ADF collaborators arrested.
Our forces in Ntoroko, both the police and UPDF, managed to carry out a cordon and search operation in Kisege village, that is Karugutu sub-county in Ntoroko district, and we managed to arrest 34 suspected wrong persons, not known by the local leaders, and persons who didn't have substantive identification documents with them.
According to police, these beefed up security along the border points to ensure that ADF rebels do not cross into the country.
The district security committees came up with the security strategies on how to, first of all, counter the different forms of threats against their district. So every district, Chegegwa, Fort Poto, Ntoroko, and so came up with their own district security arrangement.
Meanwhile, two students of St. Charles Luanga in Shema district were arrested for disguising as ADF rebels and threatening to burn their school. According to police, the two male students, aged 16 and 17 years, in senior one, authored a letter threatening to carry out an attack similar to that of Luwiriha Secondary School in Kasese District.
The terror incident which occurred at Luwiriha Secondary School, and of course they used that incident and some other existing threats, and they managed to come up with a written letter threatening their school. So we managed to arrest two senior one students for an anonymous terroristic threat against their school.
From the Directorate of Traffic and Road Safety, at least 77 people were killed in road crashes in the past 1 week. Superintendent of Police Michael Kananura, the traffic police spokesperson, says last week 447 road crashes were registered, 67 of them were fatal and 235 were serious.
Among the fatalities registered, 338 people were moving or traveling on motorcycles, both passengers and riders themselves. 26 were pedestrians, and out of the injured people, 196 were on motorcycles.
The crashes were attributed to a number of factors, including reckless driving, overspeeding, among others. He went ahead and issued guidelines to motorists using different roads.
Private vehicles and motorcycles must not drive beyond 100 kilometers per hour on paved roads, 80 kilometers per hour on gravel roads, and must not drive beyond 50 kilometers per hour in built up areas or trading centers.
From the Uganda Prison Services, at least 15 people were arrested for looting bags of maize flour, beans and soya from a prison's lorry that got involved in a road accident. Prison spokesperson Frank Waine says that the hunt for more suspects is still on, further appealing to locals that participated in the looting to surrender the stolen items before they are arrested.
The benefit we got from those who had come was to loot everything that was in that vehicle. And the law has started catching up with them. So now that when they started hunting those, searching houses and getting some of these things which had been stolen from the lorry, now people are calling me left and right. They should be helped. There is a problem. There is no problem.
Rich Nachuala reporting for the news.